Tonight we're going to play the music of Bix Beiderbecke. We're going to play tunes that he recorded and some tunes that he wrote. That first one was actually the first record Bix ever made. He was 20 years old. The year was 1924, and it was with a band called the Wolverines, a little bit before Hans Zurbrück played in the band. And we're going to continue with a record that he made a year or so later with a band called Gene Goldkit. Based out of Detroit. This is called My Pretty Girl, and we're going to feature Scott Robinson on the C Melody saxophone.
Thank you.
time that Bix Beiderbecke was working with the Gene Goldkit Orchestra, he went into the recording studio with some of the same members of that band. In fact, Frank Trumbauer on C Melody saxophone, this instrument that Scott's playing, and recorded some records that have since become classics. They're considered the first instance of the jazz ballad. And we're going to do two of them for you now, Singin' the Blues and I'm Comin' Virginia. And I'll play Bix's solos note for note because I can't improve on them.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And thank you, BIX, wherever you are. Now it's my great pleasure to introduce Marty Grosz.
Thank you, Randy. A number recorded by BIX Beiderbecke in 1928 with Paul Whiteman's orchestra, Paul Weissmann, called Changes. Changes are chords that you play on the guitar or the banjo or the piano or the organ or the dudelsack. It's played by the Begleitinstrumente, Hinter dem Soloist. And in 1928, Walter Donaldson wrote a song called Changes, and it goes like this. Changes, changes, that's all he can play. Changes, changes, he plays them all day. So sweet, so I repeat. Changes, changes, just hear while I play. He says those beautiful changes in different keys. Beautiful changes and harmony. He starts in C and changes to D. He's messing around on steady old key. Hear that minor string. That's it, there it goes again. Why, there are so many babies that he can't squeeze, but he's always changing those keys. First, change into B, change into D, change into E, as easy as the weatherman. Folks, getting kinda cold, getting kinda hot. Listen, I forgot, since he was a tot, he's been the talk of Dixieland. And harmonies. He starts in C and changes to D. He's messing around on steady old key. What's that? Hear that minor string. That's it, there it goes again. Why, there's so many babies that that cat can't squeeze, but he's always changing, rearranging. He's always changing those subtle centers.
Marty, yes. Would you treat us all to your bilingual rendition of Mississippi Mud?
Okay, Randy. 6 weeks before I came over here, for 6 Wochen, I saw an ad in the New York Times, an advertisement, and it said, speak German like a diplomat in 6 weeks. So I went to Berlitz and I signed up. And you're going to hear the results. Das Resultat wird ihr jetzt hören. And I have chosen for my text the well-known song by Harry Barris, recorded by Bing Crosby and his Alpine Yodelers, with BIX Beiderbecke on the cornet. And the song is Mississippi Mud, Mississippi Schlamm, or Mississippi Much. Mississippi Much hört sich ein bisschen besser an. So mehr rhythmisch, so zu sagen. Speak German like a diplomat. Danke. Thank you. Thank you. So, speak German like a diplomat. Guten Abend, Herr Bundeskanzler. Anyway, here we go. Mississippi Mud.
when the sun goes down and the tide goes out, the folks gather round and they all begin to shout, hey, hey, Uncle Judd, it's a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a treat to beat your feet on the Mississippi mud. What a dance do they do? Lordy, how I'm telling you. They don't need your band. They keep time by clapping their hands. Just as happy as a cow chewing on a cud when the folks beat their feet on the Mississippi mud. Wenn die Sonne untergeht und die Flut abnimmt, tun sich Leute zusammen und fangen an zu singen. Hey, hey, Onkel Franz, ein Genuss, mit den Füßen in den Matsch zu platschen. Was Genuss, mit den Füßen in den Matsch zu platschen. Was für ein Tanz tun die? Oh Gott, lieber Gott, ich sage es dir, sie benötigen keine Kapelle. Sie halten Takt durch Hände klatschen. Fröhlich wie eine Kuh, die wieder kaut, wenn die Leute mit den Füßen in den Mississippi platschen. Wenn die Leute mit den Füßen in den Mississippi platschen. Die Leute mit den Füßen in den Mississippi platschen.
Marty Grosz.
Marty is going to sing on these next two selections, too. We're going to play some tunes that BIX recorded at the height of his fame with the Paul Whiteman Orchestra. The first one is There Ain't No Sweet Man Worth the Salt of My Tears.
Weeping willow, weeping on my pillow. For years and years, there ain't no sweet man that's worth the salt of my tears. Down and down he dragged me, like a fiend he nagged me. For years and years, there ain't no sweet man that's worth the salt of my tears. Although I may be blue, still I'm through. I must tell him goodbye. Rather than have that man gonna lay me down and just die. Oh, broken-hearted sisters, aggravating misters, lend me your ears. There ain't no sweet man that's worth the salt of my tears. Thank you.
about Scott Robinson on the bass saxophone. This is another one of those tunes that Bix recorded with Paul Whiteman, and it was written by the same man who wrote Changes, Walter Donaldson. This is called Because My Baby Don't Mean Maybe Now.
Because my baby don't mean maybe now. When the preacher questions me, I'll say yes sir, yes siree. Because my baby don't mean maybe now. I just got a little letter just yesterday, and I feel a little better, so I'll say life is fine and mighty sweet, and I know mine is quite complete. Because my baby don't mean maybe now.
Also composed some pieces for the piano. That was his second instrument. And we're going to do two of them now. The first will be done as a piano solo by Mark Shane, and it's the more famous of the two. It's called In a Mist. And then we're going to follow that with my arrangement of Candlelights. Mark Shane. thought it might be interesting to play this next tune, which BIX recorded with a small group under his own name, BIX and His Gang, as a transcription of the original recording. So we're going to start off playing note for note what they played, and then halfway through we'll shift gears and just do it our own way. This is called Sorry. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And now I'd like to introduce Dan Barrett on the trombone.
Thank you very much. Here's a relatively obscure song recorded by Bix Beiderbecke when he was with Frank Trumbauer's orchestra. It's called Wait Till You See Ma Chérie. And our trio version will also feature Mark Shane at the piano and Linc Milliman at the bass.
Dan Barrett. Mark Shane, Linc Milliman. Now we're going to do a tune that Bix recorded twice in his life, first with the Wolverines and then with Frank Trumbauer. And it was written by his friend, Hoagy Carmichael, the man that I'm sure most of you know wrote Stardust and Georgia on My Mind. Hoagy originally called this tune Freewheeling, and then Bix renamed it Riverboat Shuffle, and that's what it's been ever since. So this is Riverboat Shuffle. It's my great pleasure to introduce the this year's winner of the Deutsche Schallplattenkritiken Award for the best jazz record, Ken Peplowski.
Thank you very much. Danke schön. I took the Berlitz course for 2 weeks. And Right now we're going to play a tune that BIX and his gang played quite often back then, and it's recorded by Benny Goodman and many other people. And this is called China Boy, or, as I learned in my Berlitz course, Chinesischer Junge.
Ratajczak. I think you sold a few records tonight, Ken.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you like that, please see me afterwards, and I'll tell you how to get my latest record, Ken Peplowski Plays Benny Goodman and Loses.
To make a quick segue, Ken just mentioned Benny Goodman. Ken and Dan and I were fortunate enough to play with Benny Goodman's last big band for the last 2 years of Benny's life. And there was a little period in 1930 that Benny Goodman and Bix Beiderbecke worked together, too. Of course, Benny lived to be 77 years old. He had a nice, long life. Bix died much too soon. He only lived to be 28 years old. And we're going to do a tune now that he did in the last year of his life. And this is one that Benny Goodman was on the original, and Marty Grosz is going to sing on this, as he did on the original. No, excuse me. And this is called I'll Be a Friend with Pleasure.
Thank you. da di da 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 di. I'll be a friend with pleasure.
Grosz on vocal. We're going to close our part of tonight's concert with a tune that Bix recorded with his gang. It was originally done by the original Dixieland Jazz Band, and it happens to be the title of tonight's musical festivities. This is At the Jazz Band Ball.
Thank you. Sandke and the New York All Stars. Gentlemen, thank you. How about them? Please. Okay. Gentlemen, can we have some lunch? Thank you, Randy. Thank you, gentlemen. All Stars.
It's a big singer too. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. We'll do one more for you. Thank you. We're going to play a tune that Bix recorded with Frank Trombauer. It's another one of the Dixieland favorites written by the original Dixieland jazz band. This is called Clarinet Marmalade. Thank you.
New York Coast Guard, ladies and gentlemen. And the Sandke, the New York Coast Guard. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. How about these guys? At a hotel. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so very much for that. The Sandke, the New York Coast Guard.
Marty Grosz,
shall I speak English? Shall I speak German?
We go back and forth. Grosz is not an American name.
No.
A German name.
Ein deutscher Name.
Das bedeutet, geboren wo?
Berlin.
In Berlin. Und als Baby schon nach Amerika?
Ja, als ich war 3 Jahre alt. Es war kein Jazz. No Jazz came up the Spree.
No.
So I had to go to America.
Were your parents already involved in music?
My mother played piano. You know, everybody's mother played piano.
Yeah,
why would we be?
Piano,
where would I we mean, be without the mothers of the
yeah,
world?
Right.
They all play piano. And my father tried to play banjo. He saw in Berlin in the '20s. Paul Whiteman was over, I think, Dresden irgendwo, and then there was the Chocolate Kitties Review, and then Sam Wooding's orchestra, and so forth. And he talked about that. And he tried to play banjo, but it didn't work. No good.
No good.
Yeah.
When did you start?
I started when I was about 13. Actually, I played the ukulele first. It didn't work. I was 8 years old, and it didn't make enough noise.
Sounds great in Hawaii, but
It didn't make enough noise in New York.
Yeah.
New York's the drums and trombone and things like that, saxophone.
But one thing amazes me now: as a baby, you moved to America, and you still speak German today.
Yes, because we spoke German at home, and we had all during the. 30s and 40s, we had refugees from Germany staying at our house. My father would
they
had to have some kind of credentials
to stay, yeah.
You know, and citizen, and that they would have a job and some place to stay. So the whole house was always full of these guys: Professoren, communists, all kinds of anti-Nazis, and so forth. The whole house was full of them, and they chattered away in German all day long. And then later on, I was in the U.S. Army in Germany.
In Germany.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In Landsberg. Yeah.
And how isn't that one thing that amazes me is if somebody who originally comes from Germany is in America, is this music is in Berlin never existed.
No, it well, I mean, when you think about it, really, it's not so unusual. There are many jazz musicians who can trace their origins to German roots. I can only need to mention, you know, the reason we're here, the Big Spiderbeck. Trumbauer, Teegarten, Mel Stitzel, Arthur Schutt, piano player, Johnny Münzenberger.
I think we have to stop here because we're giving the impression that somebody in Germany is to blame for all the good music that comes out of America.
No.
You know?
No, it's everything. Jelly Roll Morton said it's every, you know, and he's right, it's everybody. Italian, German, Spanish. This, that, and the other thing.
Now, when you're not playing with, are you regularly playing with Randy, for example?
Well, we play together once in a while. I've used Randy on a record date that I did 6 months ago, and we see each other around New York and stuff. But you know the way the business is nowadays, you never seldom play one place for more than one night. Then you're on go someplace else. So everything is a little bit. Unfortunately, it's so. It's very nice to have an organized band to keep it together, but everybody has to go here and there.
I know that Randy plays also different musical styles.
Yes.
Do you have another style that you also play, or what is your? Where is your heart?
No. Where's my heart? Good question. My musical roots, I think, are in Chicago, someplace. I grew up with that kind of music. And then I always liked the music of the early 30s of Waller and that kind of stuff, right. And of course Louis and so. But I'm one of the few guys that plays acoustic guitar, no amplifier. It's rhythm guitar. It's that. So I'm another German, Karl Kress, guitar player, was one influence on me, and Dick McDonough and guys like that. And my roots are back in that kind of thing, really.
The younger generation, are there people that go into this today?
Not too many. I'd like to be optimistic. I'd like to be able to say, it's great, you know, but what they turn out at the music schools and the colleges and stuff are different things. They turn out guys that will teach music, basically. They don't turn out performers. I mean, jazz music, I always felt jazz music was sort of a defiant thing, a little bit sarcastic, ironic. And we were always anti-establishment. When we were kids playing jazz, it was an anti-establishment thing. And a little bit poking fun at the, when I was a kid, at the big bands.
Right.
Everybody was sitting there. They're all sitting there with this music in front of them. And the band leaders, Tommy Dorsey and Harry James, they got more and more music. Violins. What's 5 saxes? 6 saxes? 7 saxes? You know, and they always are trying to pile in more junk on there. And then they had harps and all this junk added. And we were always wanted to play in a little joint, some smoky little joint someplace, and thumb our noses at it, you know.
Right. And there's also something that I don't know if I'm correct, but there seemed to be more humor amongst the elder musician than the younger generation today.
Huh, that's funny. I don't know why. Maybe they take themselves too seriously. I don't see it as the guys that I liked, I mean, the Red Allens and the Louis Armstrongs and the Fats Wallers and the Eddie Condon stuff and the Pee Wee Russells, they took themselves, you know, there were a few guys that took them, at least on the surface, very seriously. Very Ben Webster, Coleman Hawkins. They seemed to put up almost an invisible sign saying, "Don't fool around. Don't mess around with me." And Bechet would, you know, like this. By the same token, there are a lot of guys who had a lot of fun out of it, you know. And I always, I'm with those.
You're with those. Yeah.
Although I like the other playing, you know. Just playing is one thing.
Now, do you, at that point in your career, do you still envision something in the music business that you haven't reached yet, or is there still the hidden dream somewhere?
You know what they asked Pee Wee Russell once he won the Downbeat Award late in his career, and he all of a sudden he was rediscovered. He made those records with a quartet. And somebody, a friend of mine, encountered him at a coffee shop, and they were, "Hello, Pee-wee, what's happening?" And Pee-wee said, "I just want a gig." So the main thing is just to play someplace. Yeah, I have a few young guys that are a few bass players that play without amplifiers, and there's a couple of them that I know, and a few young guys that we have little trios and quartets and stuff like that, and there's still hope to work once in a while with that.
Well, I'll tell you something, there is the big word in the music industry that caters to the very young today is unplugged.
I haven't heard it, have you?
Yes.
Where is it?
You know, like MTV television, yeah, where they have all those videos with pop music.
Yeah.
They have discovered something they call unplugged. That means no electronics anymore. So the times might change.
You never know. Okay. That would be good. A little that kind of a. You see, you just with electricity, you just can't get that beat. It's not the same. You don't have it. It's too easy. And if it's too easy, like with bass and with drums, if it's too easy. And the guys who played with the horn right in the microphone, they were talking about Louis just now. Louis had this ring here,
right,
the pressure, and Cootie Williams had the ring, and Bunny Berrigan and Roy Eldridge, so forth and so on. And you hear it in their playing. Red Allen, they have this intensity, this kind of dead, 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 dead. And the same thing with the guitar or with the bass, things like that. If it's too easy, it doesn't swing. It doesn't have the push, you know,
right.
The resistance.
So now we hope that the times are changing, and we hope to see you again.
I hope to see myself again, too.
Yeah, right. And thank you for...
Oh, thank you. Time. Thank you for having me.